Texas, and it says, I'm a guitar player. What is the easiest way to learn theory? So the answer is that you have to get a way that you can apply what you learn in theory. Because in theory there is no difference between practice and theory, but in practice there is, because there will be a gap. So what you learn in theory, why it is, sometimes people think it's boring or something. It's not boring, but people see it that way sometimes because they don't know how to use it. If you learn how to use what you learn in theory in your practice, daily practice, etc., then you will see how, wow, this is useful because I can play better with it. And then that way you get the motivation to learn theory. Otherwise, this, if you learn just theoretical things which you do not apply, stuff that, like, you know, I learned algebra or other stuff in the school and I don't remember it anymore. Why? Because I never apply it again. I never use it. I use adding, subtracting, multiplication, division, and that's all. But these other equations in math, we don't use this in daily life, and then I forgot it. And of course, it was a nightmare to study it, just to pass exams. So this is theory things in music, I mean guitar also especially, should be pointed at stuff that you can apply. In my study program, that's exactly what we do in Skype, I give you some theory if you want, and also how you can use that. And then therefore, people sometimes now, in fact, have students that are liking more theory than the playing pieces or anything. Why? Because your horizon expands. So best way to learn theory is by learning how to apply the theory in practice.
Mira, yo lo que descubrí ahí es la improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música, debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando, de cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías están en cada momento, ¿no?
Muy bien, Pablo.
Sí, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.